Hello guys, I'm Kiri, welcome back to my channel. Today we're gonna talk about the Italian beauty from 1964, Bizzarrini GT Strada 5300. This was a Gran Turismo car produced between 1964 and 1968, and only 133 cars were built. There were some roadster version as well, but the most well known is the coupe type. The designer of the car was Giotto Bizzarrini, who himself also built the car. Giotto Bizzarrini was main engineer at Ferrari, and one of his projects is the famous Ferrari model 250 GTO. Then he split up from Ferrari and made his own company. Even Bizzarrini won 1965 Le Mans race in his class and finished 9th in overall. After he split up from Ferrari, was very motivated, and then the result is came, the legendary car Bizzarrini GT Strada 5300, which he wanted to make better than Ferrari F250 GTO. GT is coming from Gran Turismo, Strada is coming from road in Italian language, and 5300 is coming from the capacity of the engine, which is V8 5358cc and was from Chevrolet Corvette small block 327 with 365 horsepower or 385 horsepower in some models in the street versions and 400 horsepower for the Corsa racing. The gearbox was 4-speed manual BorgWarner T10, and thanks to this the maximum speed of the car was 280 km per hour. The acceleration from 0 to 100 km per hour or 62 miles per hour was just 7 seconds. Dunlop 4-wheel disc brakes, independent front suspension, Dedion tube rear suspension and limited slip differential. The Giorgetto Giugiaro influenced Bertone's tired aluminium body. The car was long 4 meter 460. The wheelbase of the car was 2 meter 450. Was wide 1 meter 760. Was high 1 meter 120. And the weight of the car was 1200 kilograms. Was ostensibly a street car, but with specification like a race car. It had light aluminium body by BBM of Modena, a fabricated platform, chassis and a semi-monocoque body riveted to the frame. Was amazing, very high technology on that time. Giotto Bizzarrini graduated himself in the University of Pisa in 1953, then he started to work for Alfa Romeo, and then very quickly he moved to Ferrari, where he been very successful, where he was largely responsible for the developments of many of what would become the Ferrari most iconic cars, like Ferrari 250 Testarossa 1957, Ferrari GT 250 GT short wheelbase, very famous car, and the most famous, what I said before, Ferrari 250 GTO. So thanks to him, we have today these very famous Ferrari models. Then he designed the very well-known, very successful and long-time produced Lamborghini V12. So, and then he helped Lamborghini, Ferruccio Lamborghini, to create his very famous engine V12. When he started to build and designed his car, GT 5300 Strada, he said, "I started with the idea of the 250 GTO. And set about trying to improve it." So this was what Giotto Bizzarrini said when he started his car. You can see here the sign Bizzarrini on the boot, and the rear side of the car looks really absolutely amazing, with these chrome bumpers, the four exhausts, two on left and two on right side, the big air intakes from behind the rear wheels. Is like Ferrari 250 GTO. Ferrari 250 GTO has similar to this, behind the rear wheels. So this is because just Giotto Bizzarrini was working for this project, Ferrari 250 GTO. And it's absolutely beautiful design in this red color. Absolutely amazing. You can see here on the side of the car the sign GT5300 Strada. Absolutely amazing car. Inside is piece of art, Italian piece of art, with the wooden steering wheel, with the leather. It's absolutely beautiful. Outside as well, the lights, you can see, absolutely perfectly made Italian car from 1960s. The wheels as well, they're with one nut, so Borani. The lights there cover. So guys, I hope you like the video about the Bizzarrini 5300 GT Strada. Please subscribe my channel and see you next time, guys. Bye.